A ship is riding majestically toward us like some great feather. Riding the sword was mighty proud of the place it's playing in the world's aviation. The ship is no doubt bustling with activities we can see. Orders are shouted to the crew. The passengers probably lining the windows looking down at the field ahead of them, getting their glimpse of the mooring mast. And these giant flagships standing here, the American Airline flagships, waiting to rise into all points in the United States when they get the ship moored. There are a number of important persons is on board, and no doubt the new commander, Captain Max Pierce, is thrilled too, for this is his great moment, the first time he's commanded the Hindenburg. On previous flights, he acted as the chief officer under Captain Lehman. It's practically standing still now. They've dropped ropes out of the nose of the ship, and it's been taken a hold of down on the field by a number of men. It's starting to rain again. The rain had flashed up a little bit. The back motors of the ship are just holding it just enough to keep it from... It bursts into flames. Wait, get it started. It's crashing terrible. Oh, my, get out of the way, please. It's burning, bursting into flames, and it's falling on the mooring fast, and all the folks would agree that this is terrible. This is one of the worst catastrophes in the world. Oh, it's... Four or 500 feet into the sky. It's a terrific crash, ladies and gentlemen. The smoke and the flames now, and the frame is crashing to the ground, not quite to the mooring mast. Oh, the humanity and all the passengers screaming around here. I told you, I can't even talk to people as friends are out there. I can't talk, ladies and gentlemen. Honest, it's just like there, a massive smoking wreckage. And everybody can't hardly breathe and talk and scream. Lady, I'm sorry. Honestly, I can hardly breathe. I'm going to step inside, but I cannot see it.